So, you're watching your favorite medical TV drama. It's getting super intense. There's a critically ill patient and all of a sudden he flatlines. Bam! The doctor's on the scene. He or she pulls out the paddles and shouts, clear! The patient may jerk a bit and boom! The patient's heart restarts. They wake up normally without CPR and the patient lives. Everyone celebrates and the doctor's a hero, right? Well, this isn't what happens in real life. At all. So the machine that they use to help revive a patient who has suffered a heart attack or a cardiac arrest is called a defibrillator, and it does so by providing an electric shock and allowing clinicians to begin CPR.
Staying alive.
On TV, however, the defibrillators must be magical because they work quite differently and have a much higher success rate than they do in real life. The thing is that on TV, defibrillators seem to work by restarting the heart of someone who has flatlined, meaning that there's no heartbeat, and then they get it back to beating again. But this actually isn't how they work. In actual fact, defibrillators stop the heart from beating if it's beating abnormally. So they're reversing fibrillation, essentially, and they're not used on a patient who is flatlining, but if they are used on a patient that is flatlining, then the patient will first be given a round of drugs such as epinephrine to jumpstart the heart into any kind of activity, even just a tiny twitch, which can then be shocked, and then CPR is used to try and get it back to a normal rhythm. So you do need CPR to get the heart going again once you've stopped it. Defibrillators are very common in medical dramas. I'm sure you've all seen at least one scene where a patient has been brought back to life with one. Some medical dramas that are more unrealistic in general will use this technique on a flatlining patient, while others, such as ER, that seem to prefer to place accuracy over dramatic license, won't.
Yeah, it's a medical drama, but with the emphasis on drama rather than medicine. I think you get far too bogged down in so-called research.
Yeah, the producer arranged for us to follow a team of paramedics around for a month, but instinctively, that felt wrong.
I mean, a month.
Yeah.
But of course, you have shows like Scrubs, where it's just used for comedy, and you know that they're not trying to be medically accurate and just want to make you laugh. Like in that episode where JT has his first code and Turk gets there first and shocks a flatlining patient who actually just had a faulty monitor and was just sleeping.
Wing.
Charge! Clear!
And then another one that's commonly seen on TV is the bare cable method.
Now, just in case I'm incapacitated for some reason, do you know how to start a man's heart with a downed power line?
No.
Well, there's really no wrong way to do it.
So, there's this episode of Mr. Bean where he uses jump leads to shock a man back to life, and it works until it doesn't. But this method can actually sometimes be justified, but generally it will actually just induce the need to be defibrillated. But it's not just the action of the defibrillator that is kind of embellished for both the little and the big screen, but a heart attack itself is also generally not portrayed the way it normally happens. So someone is going along in their daily life, just reading the newspaper, when suddenly they have a shooting pain in their left arm, and within seconds they stagger, clutching at their chest, when they drop like a stone to the floor, unconscious, and probably dead, right? But in real life, heart attacks are not always like that, and they can vary in their nature. Yes, of course, you can have an instantaneous death with chest clutching dramatics, but you can also have it where someone doesn't even realize that they've had one until years and years later, when an ECG discovers the damage left behind. And of course, a heart attack might not show up on an ECG at all, which is why they do additional testing in the event of a negative ECG when there are symptoms of a heart attack. Because only a third of ECGs carried out actually detect a heart attack has occurred. And while some women do have chest pain, some of the more common heart attack symptoms in women include things like nausea, dizziness, heartburn, and feeling faint. So heart attacks can really go completely unnoticed and don't always need a defibrillator. And of course, on the flip side, you can think you're having a heart attack when you're not. And if you would like more medical related drama in your life, especially now you know what to look out for so you're not fooled no more, I would definitely recommend getting your hands on Adam Kay's This Is Going to Hurt. If you haven't already heard of it, where have you been? Everybody that I've spoken to that has read it or listened to it has absolutely loved it. Adam has taken a bit of poetic license with this a little bit, but most of it is true. And luckily I've teamed up with Audible to give you all a free audiobook. And they of course have This Is Going to Hurt read by the author himself. Audible is so great. I really love it for long trips, especially now that I've moved far away for uni. But you can listen on any device, anywhere, anytime, at home, at the gym, on your commute, and if you're not enjoying an audiobook, you can exchange it. And once something is in your audiobook library, it's yours forever, even if you cancel. So head on over to audible.com/sciencewithkatie, where you can start your 30-day free trial, and you can pick one audiobook and two Audible originals for absolutely free, or you can text Science with Katie to 500-500. And on top of that, if you finish the three books by the 3rd of March, you'll get $20 Amazon credit. Amazing! So go check it out, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more, hit subscribe. A big thank you to my patrons on Patreon, and thank you for watching. Bye!